been getting a lot of questions lately about General MacArthur, General Jonathan Wainwright, and the Medal of Honor. Mostly, did MacArthur object to Wainwright receiving the Medal of Honor? And the short answer to that is yes. And now for some background information. When MacArthur was ordered to Australia in 1942, Wainwright was put in command of all the forces in the Philippines. On April 9th, 1942, the forces on Bataan were surrendered. Wainwright then pledged to hold Corregidor, but there isn't a military planner or historian today who believes that by that point the Philippines could have been held. And in May of 1942, under great duress, Wainwright surrenders all remaining forces to the Japanese. MacArthur is very, very upset about the fall of the Philippines. In July of 1942, Army Chief of Staff George C. Marshall sends MacArthur a message asking him to support the Medal of Honor nomination for Wainwright. The proposed citation includes mentions of Bataan, of Corregidor, and of Wainwright being an example to all. MacArthur demurs, and he sends a message to General Marshall that begins with the text, "For General Marshall's eyes alone." And he explains in this message that he had already awarded Wainwright the Distinguished Service Cross and was also planning on recommending him for the Distinguished Service Medal and the Legion of Merit. He writes that those are appropriate awards for Wainwright, but he makes it clear that Wainwright falls far short of the requirements for the award of the Medal of Honor. But why would he do this? Why would someone who was ordered out of the Philippines object to the Medal of Honor for someone who was left behind? Why would someone whose own Medal of Honor is somewhat controversial object to a Medal of Honor for someone in this situation? It's possible that he was upset with Wainwright for the surrender, but his message to Marshall actually hints at something else. He says he opposes the Medal of Honor because he wishes to avoid the inclusion of my adverse observations and opinion and certain facts into Wainwright's record, which would now serve no useful purpose. He also makes a point that there are other officers in the command that he believes contributed more to the stability of that command than Wainwright. And then he also ends the message with an idea that giving Wainwright the Medal of Honor could lead to embarrassing repercussions in the future. What is he talking about? A clue may come from the oral history Colonel John Carter did with MacArthur biographer D. Clayton James in 1971. Carter, who commanded the 91st Infantry of the Philippines 91st Division, told James that Wainwright was a courageous and conscientious leader, but that he liked the bottle. Carter said that at one point during the retreat from Lingayen to Bataan, Wainwright was in his tent and could not be seen by anyone. He told James to draw his own conclusions about this episode. Now, Wainwright's alcoholism was well known in the pre-war days, and it was observed as well in the post-war years. As commander of all the forces in the Philippines during that retreat, did MacArthur know about this particular episode? Is that what he's talking about when he tells Marshall he doesn't want to voice his reasons for his objection to Wainwright's Medal of Honor? No one really knows. Meanwhile, Wainwright had gone into captivity thinking that he was the biggest failure for surrendering. During the war, he would be the highest-ranking American POW, but his treatment in prisoner-of-war camps in the Philippines, in Formosa, in China, would not reflect that status. After liberation in August of 1945, he was reunited with MacArthur in Japan. MacArthur was shocked by his haggard appearance, and as they embraced, his frustration over the surrender kind of evaporated. MacArthur also made a point of giving Wainwright a place of honor during the Japanese surrender on the USS Missouri, and even gave Wainwright one of the signing pens during the ceremony. At this point, MacArthur did nothing further to derail or protest the effort to award Wainwright the Medal of Honor. And Wainwright eventually received this honor at the White House in September 1945 after he returned to the United States. An officer who served with MacArthur and with Wainwright described them this way. MacArthur was like Moses, kind of parting the waters, and Wainwright was more like a King Saul leading his men into battle. Of the officers that served with both men, the uniform opinion is pretty much that both men were devoted to the army, devoted to duty, and devoted to the United States, but two very, very different men. Now, there's no doubt that Wainwright inspired others and that he exhibited great courage, but he was also someone who struggled terribly with addiction. He was a cavalryman, and he was also a great animal lover, and he's one of the few generals who talks about the suffering of animals and men in war. In his writings, and you really can't read about him without getting a sense that he experienced the suffering of living things very, very keenly. It was personal. As the situation deteriorated in the Philippines in 1942, he was forced to have his beloved horse and the mounts of the other cavalrymen slaughtered to provide food for the beleaguered defenders. He ordered that his horse be the first killed. He was willing to make deep personal sacrifices to care for those around him. And sometimes he coped very well, sometimes he didn't. But he was a very gentle and humble man in many ways, and I think that made people care deeply for him. So much so that when he failed, those around him were more than willing to compensate. And it says a lot about his quality that those who served with him did everything they could to try to limit any mention of his personal struggles in any of the official records.